town, to come back to Tuba City. I gotta say, I spent a portion of my childhood around here. My dad was an artist, and he taught me about listening. Listening to people all over wherever you are, right, particularly this state. And it was a lesson that he instilled in me that I take with me to what I'm doing today. So it's an honor to be back here now, and I'm on a different listening tour. I'm on a listening tour for a very important office that people don't quite understand what the Secretary of State does. The Secretary of State should really be thought of as an office of protection, protecting the right to vote, and protecting heritage. It's the chief librarian and archivist and historian for the state. It's the one office that's supposed to unify us as Arizonans, no matter our different backgrounds, no matter where in the state that we live, no matter what we do or who we are. So this office is a very important office, particularly right now, because we're living in a very divided, divisive time. And unfortunately, we have a Secretary of State right now who is very different from any Secretary of State I've been around the country. Very different from the Secretary of State that I grew up with in Arizona. I grew up under Rose Moffitt. Any of you remember Rose Mofford? Everybody loved Rose, whether you were a Democrat or Republican, no matter which county you lived in the state, no matter your background. She was there to serve Arizona, and to serve Arizonans, and to be there to be for Arizona. Right now, we have a Secretary of State that's very different. She has put out more obstacles to voting rights than I, as a 26-year voting rights watchdog and election protection attorney around the country. Michelle Rabin, our current Secretary of State, has put up more obstacles to people voting, more voting rights violations, than I've ever seen in 26 years in my work all across the country. And unfortunately, it's right here in Arizona. And we have enough troubles here in Arizona. When we go out of the state, we say we're from Arizona. They talk about our politics enough. They talk about all the problems we have across the state with our politics. We're known for that, and we certainly don't need our voting system to be contributing to that problem. And unfortunately, it has. Because we have lack of leadership in this office, the second highest office in the state, that has divided us instead of doing its function, which is to unite us as Arizonans. So, as I said, I'm on a listening tour. I want to hear from you while I'm here, and I want to continue to hear every time that I come up here about issues you have with voting, issues that you have with not being having your heritage and your culture and your history and your sites represented and respected by the state and cherished by the state. Because the one office that's supposed to be doing that, the one office that's supposed to be doing that is the Secretary of State's office. So, a little more background. I'm Mark Robert Gordon. I'm an Arizona native. My dad was a disabled World War II veteran. My mom was a public school teacher who had to work four jobs at one point to take care of my family. And my dad, you know, in World War II, fought for this country. He was a lone survivor of three airplane crashes. He was at D-Day. He liberated one of the death camps that the Nazis had. To not be able to vote would have crushed him, because citizenship was everything. And in the Arizona that I remember, we used to help people vote. We used to encourage people to vote. We would do anything we could to make it easier for people to vote. That's what got me into doing voting rights law. In Arizona, I remember people, if you couldn't make it out of your house to vote, such as my dad, with his disability, you could ask anybody that could help you vote. You just needed a notary to come and say that this was, you know, your vote that was going in. And so we used to have people come to the house from the Democratic Party, from bankers, from notaries in the neighborhood,
come in to help them vote. Today, it's a felony in Arizona to help someone vote that way, unless you're a household member, an election official, or a home healthcare attendant. It's a felony to help someone vote. That's the crime, is standing in the way of people exercising that most important, important and essential freedom we have as Americans. So that's what got me interested, my dad's experience in voting. I've been doing voting rights around the country. I run a national law office where I go and protect the vote in states and counties all around the country, bringing down barriers, including here in Arizona, last 5 years as the Maricopa County Election Integrity Director. We have a new county recorder in Arizona that brought me aboard as his election specialist for his transition team to bring the office up to speed on best practices, make sure that the system was working for everybody, for you. This is what I want to do on the state level. And the one mistake that our current Secretary of State made from the beginning, to bring it back to my beginning here, was not listening. Unlike prior Secretaries of State, Democrat or Republican, who listened to other populations, to other counties. The Secretary of State went to war with the county recorders in all 15 counties, Democrat and Republican. That's not how you start off. You start off by going on a listening tour, by hearing what's on people's minds, by finding what the problems are and trying to come up with solutions together. That's what I'm trying to do. I'm Mark Robert Gordon. I'm running for Secretary of State. I need your help. My campaign manager is here with a petition to get me on the ballot. If you haven't signed for Secretary of State, please sign the petition. Please take one of our pamphlets, go online if you have online access, and follow us. And tell your neighbors, tell your friends. And I'll be back up here, I promise. And I thank you for your time.